Thanks a lot. Another breaking news story, and this one's sure to get some attention if you're in this area, the Mount Adams area of Cincinnati. Just getting some details on this. You know, we've had some strong wind in the area. Apparently, a 4- or 5-story tall scaffolding all wrapped in plastic been blowing around, and it kind of has a kite effect. This thing blew down right across the street over some power lines. Duke Energy has crews on the scene trying to figure out a plan on this, but this is in the area of Baum and Oregon Street. Again, some scaffolding down over the wires in Mount Adams.
In other local news tonight, Cincinnati police now looking for a couple of wannabe thieves who went through a lot of trouble for nothing in the end. Investigators say the crooks first stole a front loader before trying to steal an ATM. WLWT News 5's Brian Hamrick joining us live from the scene in Mount Adams tonight. Brian?
Yeah, well, this was thought out by some thieves who were thinking big. I mean, why not take the whole bank?
When it comes to bank robberies,
nothing surprises you anymore.
Except when the thief is armed with an end loader.
I can't believe it.
It's a plot, part mystery, part sitcom. But it has police chasing at least two suspects after they destroyed this ATM and left a gaping hole in the kiosk that housed it. This was actually the second part of the plan. The first part started here, where the thieves stole the end loader with the skills of a mischievous MacGyver.
They just took the ignition out of it and jammed a screwdriver in there and was able to fire it up.
James Warren is back in the driver's seat of that very same end loader today, where crews with Ford Development are putting in a water line just over the hill from the ATM. So who could hotwire one of these?
I would say that not very many people could do it, but they obviously knew what they were doing.
Despite all the damage they left behind here, the Dillingers of demolition didn't get a dime. They left empty-handed when they apparently couldn't get the ATM into the dump truck. No gold, but some saw a silver lining.
But at least nobody was hurt.
In a bank robbery plot that turned out to be no account.
Now, the suspects are still on the loose, and police are really looking at that connection of the construction companies. Both the end loader and the dump truck were stolen from two separate sites. Reporting live, Brian Hamrick, WLWT News 5.
All right.